You said when you died you'd walk with me every day. And I start to cry and say, please don't talk that way. With the blink of an eye, the Lord came and asked you to leave. You went to a better place.
And it's a pretty diverse mix. Like, we have designers over here. We have some salespeople. Core marketing. This guy doesn't do any work at all. He just kind of sits back. He plays games on his computer. He's kind of like a mascot.
Excellent.
Name Sebastian.
Game station. DivX. Excellent.
This is fun. We have a lot of salespeople here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's the CEO's desk. He's not very busy working. That's where he normally sits.
Hi. Hi, Matt.
Hi.
Hi.
Yeah. Digital media company. The company was formed in 2000, so we've been around for about 8 years now. The technology that fuels the company, DivX, was created in 1999 by a Frenchman named Jerome Rota, who was at that time kind of a video technologist.
But here, United States.
No, he was in France at the time. Yeah, he was in Montpellier, France.
Montpellier.
Yeah. And he was looking for a way to send kind of an online portfolio of video content to prospective employers or people on the internet. He wasn't really satisfied with the existing technological solutions at that time to let him do that. You know, the files were either too big, or if they were small, the quality was too low. So he kind of started playing around on his own, and he ran across an early implementation of a Microsoft video codec that was based on MPEG-4, and he liked it. But Microsoft made some restrictions to it, and they were using a proprietary format, ASF, that he wasn't happy with. So he kind of, without ever having the source code, he just kind of tinkered around with it himself, opened it up a bit, and added a layer of MP3 audio, and changed it to the AVI file format, and just kind of created this codec on his own, really at the time for his own personal use, because he thought it was a very efficient codec. But in kind of true internet fashion, he put it up on his own personal website. People discovered it, and it became his immense hallmark of our philosophy. So we don't believe in closed, vertical, proprietary systems like people like others do.
So the relationship to hardware providers is very important.
Extremely important.
And also from point of money.
Yes, indeed. You know, we're a public company, so you can see our financials, but something like 70% of our revenue comes from licensing. The most of the rest of it comes from software distribution, mainly in terms of advertising. So we have a deal right now with Yahoo, where we bundle the Yahoo toolbar. So when you download the free version of DivX Video, you get an offer for the Yahoo toolbar. We used to do that with Google, now we do it with Yahoo. So that provides us something like 15 to 20% of revenue, depending on the quarter. The rest of it comes from charging for the pro version of the software.
Pro version, paid version. Because the player is for free?
The player is for free, and then we have a DivX converter product, which lets you encode, which is
charged for. My files keep editing.
That's right, simple drag and drop. And then we have a more kind of sophisticated video editing application called DivX Author. Converter is $19.99, I believe, and DivX Author is $29.99, I think. Mm-hmm. The prices change occasionally, but I think that's the price. So we do derive revenue from the software side, but primarily it's from consumer electronics licensing. And the real focus for us now on the consumer electronics side is moving beyond DVD players into this whole host of other devices.
What does it mean? Mobile devices?
Mobile devices, absolutely. That's a big focus for us. Mobile phones. We would love to be on the iPod. I don't think Apple is particularly interested in this, but there are a lot of iPod-like personal media players from other companies that incorporate DivX technology. And on the mobile side, you know, we launched the kind of mobile certification program probably over a year ago, and now we have, I think, over 15 different handsets that are DivX certified, from Samsung and LG are two kind of flagship partners there, the LG Secret, which is a very popular phone, LG Beauty. Very high quality
in the media world, you know, and they want to have some small part in doing that.
They really adopt the vision.
So it's exciting to work, you know, it's exciting to work around people who share that vision and really think, you know, it's not like we're curing cancer or doing something, you know, that important, obviously, but, you do feel like you have the potential to make a difference in the way that people kind of communicate and consume information, and, you know, people believe in that here.
Walk with me every day, and I start to cry and say, please don't talk that way. With a blink of an eye, the Lord came and asked you to leave. You went to a better place, but it stole you away from me. She lives in heaven, but I know they left her to take care of me. There's a strange kind of light caressing me.